Do we have session today, guys? Guys, who hosts this session? Actually, this is my first session, so I'm not getting anything. It's already 5:07, and the session is not started.
Wait for some time. Ma'am will come.
Wait. Ma'am is coming.
The same ma'am who took the session at 5 p.m. daily. That ma'am only.
कितना जल्दी हो सके
तू पैसा ले ना
Ashish, your speaker is on.
Sorry.
Nilesh, is this your first session or you attend this session already? I'm
attend already.
Okay, so what's exactly the purpose of this session? I mean, I don't know anything. This is my first.
You know Java?
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, this regarding.
Okay, so it's just about discussion or like let's just ask some interview questions or like this?
Question with preparation, interview preparation.
Okay. Is it individual or like they just teach anything?
No, individual teaching.
Okay. Usually at what time the session start English?
Six PM.
But it's already 6:10 and there is nobody to host the session.
Bro, you have to wait, man.
Is this daily or like it's?
No, this is first time, bro.
Okay.
Good evening. Good evening, guys.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Ashish, Navni, the Mohanta.
Good evening,
Jagdish. Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. Saurabh, Tushar. Okay, good evening, guys. So, shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
So yesterday until where we have done?
Ma'am?
Yep.
What if someone is new to this class like me? It's
okay.
First day.
Yes. It's first day?
Yes.
That's fine. We are in the basic, just a drill, right? You'll have a drill, the questions. That's it. If you join regularly, like once a cycle completes, once again, it will be repeated.
Okay.
Okay. So you and even we have some others also new. Nikita. Hi, Nikita.
And
hi. So try to join regularly, Nikita, from now on. Okay.
Yeah.
So first thing, we'll be having drill, guys. So drill of the questions will be there. After completing that, we'll be just entering into mock interview style. So you need to own your videos and some sort of questions will be done for you. You need to answer the questions. That's what it happens from tomorrow. Today. That's what daily will be going on. Yes. So now, yesterday we have discussed a couple of topics, right?
Inheritance, ma'am.
Yes, inheritance. So we are in the inheritance concept. So almost inheritance is done yesterday. So today we'll go with the next topic. Aggregation is also done, right? Composition, aggregation.
Yes, ma'am.
Super keyword also done.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Object cloning.
Yes, ma'am.
Method overloading method, is also done. Overriding? No. No, right?
Some little bits.
Okay. Yep. Hi. So let's get into. So now method overriding. What is method overriding?
Ma'am, changing the implementation parent class into child class requirement is known as method overriding.
Okay.
And method overriding, private method, final method, and static method cannot be override.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Inheritance is a must need for method overriding.
Okay. So what are the rules for it? So only one is answering. I don't find any others. Please try to
ignore guys. When we write a method with same name.
In
signature parameters, and that two methods possessing is a relationship between them.
Mm-hmm.
Some basic rules for method overriding.
Okay. Overloading is nothing but compile time polymorphism, and overriding nothing but runtime polymorphism.
At the time of overriding of method, its scope should be in increased manner. Then only we can override. Suppose in parent class, if its scope is default, then in child class, we have to write public.
Okay.
purpose of method overriding to achieve a runtime polymorphism.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's all. Any other?
Method overriding is also called as dynamic binding.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. So now let me just give you a small description on it. So method overriding, basically what is method overriding in the sense, if subclass provides a specific implementation of a method that is already provided by its parent class, it is known as method overriding. It is used for runtime polymorphism and to implement the interface methods. And for this purpose, for implementing method overloading, we do have certain rules to be followed. The method must have the same name as the parent class. You are just overriding it. So same method name should have. The method must have same signature as in the parent class. The two classes must have an is-a relationship. That means two classes must be in an inheritance form. Now, the questions on this would be like, can we override the static method?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No,
ma'am.
Are you sure?
Yes, ma'am. There is no sense to override the static method because, because they are totally belongs to the class and...
Okay. No, you can't override the static method because they are part of
class,
not the object. So when you're telling yes or no, try to give why it is. Okay. Then why can we not override static method? It's a part of class and object. But I do have one more question, like, can we override the overloaded method?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
No, ma'am. We cannot.
No, I'm asking, can we override the overloaded method?
Yes, ma'am. We can override overloaded method.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, someone yes, have told, can you give why? Why it is no?
Because, ma'am, in method overloading, we passes different parameters in method signatures. But in while method overriding, we have one rule. And that is to pass same signature parameters, I mean, equal parameters that which we passes in main method, which we override in. We override that in subclass, then we have to maintain same signature parameters.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe, I'm not sure, but maybe that's.
Yes, you can override the overloaded method because you're overriding over here. Overloaded in the sense you'll be changing the parameter size and you'll be overloaded. But overriding, you're just changing the inner things. You are using the same. That is what the rules over here were. The method, two methods, or the method must have the same signature as the parent class. So overriding won't be an issue even if the method is overloaded. Clear? Yes. Can we override private methods?
No, ma'am. We can override the private methods.
Can you justify your answer?
Because we cannot access these methods outside the class. And the basic rules that we have must possess is a relationship during method overriding. So that's why we cannot override private methods.
Ma'am, private is restricted.
Yes, exactly. Good.
So it's class.
Yeah. Can we change the scope of the overridden method in the subclass?
Yes, ma'am.
But that return type must be the covariant type.
See, yep, we can, but we need to remember certain points over here. The private can be changed to protected, public, or default. That's fine. The protected can be changed to public or default. The default can be changed to public and the public will always remain public. So these are the things you need to take care of. You can change the scope, but you need to remember these kind of things before changing the scope. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, one more question over here. Can we modify the throws clause of the superclass method while overriding it in the subclass?
No.
No? Oh, yes.
Again, ma'am.
Can you repeat your question?
Can we modify the throws clause of the superclass method while overriding it in the subclass?
Yes, ma'am. We can change it.
Only Gulshan gave yes. And someone in the chat, no. Why? My answer is also yes. But I do have a justification for my answer.
I'm confused.
Confused. Okay. Once again, I'll repeat the question. Please concentrate. Okay. Can we modify the throws clause of the superclass method while overriding it in the subclass? Yes. Okay. The answer is yes. So let me just give you a small description on this. So yes, we can modify the throws clause of the superclass method while overriding it in the subclass. However, there are some rules to be followed. So the rules would be like, if the superclass method does not declare an exception, subclass overridden method cannot declare the checked exception, but it can declare the unchecked exceptions. So throws clause, in the sense there you got confused, it's under exception concept. And if the superclass method declares an exception, subclass overrides method can declare the same can be declared. And subclass exceptions are no exception but cannot declare parent exception. So here when parent it is declared, that's fine, you can just go on. And superclass does not declare an exception, then what you need to do? Subclass overriding method cannot declare the checked one. You can go with unchecked. Unchecked exceptions can be good. So this is what the case with the throws clause. This is somewhat high level and somewhat tricky. You need to think of it, basically. Clear? Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
It's in exception handlings. So I don't know, my system all of a sudden it's is it clear for you?
Yes, ma'am.
It's clear.
Yes, ma'am.
But I don't think my system is all of a sudden it's just having some blur. Okay, fine. So next comes with, can you have virtual functions in Java?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
We have, but it's a different name.
But my answer, yes, and my justification is all the functions in Java are virtual. All the functions are virtual by default. Clear? And coming to next one is, final variable. So as we discussed yesterday, this super and static now comes with final. So what is this final variable? What are the uses of the final variable? Can anyone just go ahead?
We cannot change the value of the final variable.
Final variable are
so fixed. If you change the value, it gives a compile time error.
Mm-hmm.
A final variable we can treat as a constant variable. We cannot change that variable value throughout our code.
Mm-hmm.
And say can use it for memory optimization purpose as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And we can declare local variables as final variables.
Okay. Okay, let me just give you a description. Yes, you are right. Whatever you told, that's perfectly fine. So in Java, the final variable is used to restrict the user from updating it. Yes, as a constant, you can declare it. You can't update it throughout the code. So if we initialize a final variable, we can't change its value. So once assigned, that's it. Can never be changed. So Java final variable, in the sense, you have to remember three different things. To stop value change, you can stop value change, you can stop method overwriting, and stop inheritance. That these three, you can just tell that these three are being achieved, or you can remember through final variable. Now coming to, I do have a doubt, final variable, that's fine, but what about final method? Can we give final keyword to the method and make it final?
Yes, we can't override
it. We are not able to override it.
Can we?
No, ma'am.
And if we declare a method final, then we are not able to override the child.
That's it. So you can, but you can't override it. That's it. And what about class? Can I go with the class?
You can reinherit that class, ma'am.
Yes, we can use a final keyword with class, but we cannot inherit that class.
Like when one predefined class string is already a final class.
Yes. And what is a final blank variable? Final blank variable. Final blank variable. Think of it.
Ma'am, a final blank variable, no initialization.
Yes, exactly. So here, final variable, fine, it's a final variable. We have declared it's a final variable, but we didn't initialize it. We didn't give or we didn't assign any value. That's the reason we just call it as final blank variable, which is not holding any kind of value. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So try to note like whatever points you are not missing, like you are not aware of it, each and everything, try to note it out, okay?
Is it holding the default value?
Default value, in the sense, no default value.
Like it holds the zero?
No. It won't hold. No. See, for example, PAN number, if you are not having a PAN number, then what happens? It's fine. It's blank. That's it.
On a final stat, final static variable is also blank variable.
Final static, again, it's different. What I'm talking is just final blank variable. Static, by default, it is holding a default thing, right?
Yes.
So when you're using final and static, obviously, as a static is holding some default, it has to have some default. Or else it will throw an error, as both you can't use at a time.
Yes, ma'am.
That's it. The static has its functionalities and final has its functionalities. So either two differently you need to use. If you want to use it combinedly, anyone you need to just mess it up. Only one you need to use. Now, I do have other question, guys. Just let's rectify it, okay? So, can we initialize, like once it is done with the blank, can we initialize it? Final blank variable. Can we initialize final blank variable?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes?
Yes. Using this keyword.
But here you need to think something. If it is not static, if it is static, then already it is having a default value. If it is not static, we can initialize it. Clear? Because as you asked a question, like if it is final static, then what happens? That's it. If it is final static, only the default value, you can't give any. because it's holding final. Final in the sense, that's it. You can't change the value. And if you're going with the static, as it is blank, default value will be loaded. So if it is not static, yes, you can give value for final blank variable. Can you declare the main method as final? Yes, can you declare main method as final?
Yes, ma'am. We declare main method as a final without any compile error.
Yes, we can. We can declare. We can declare. There is, you won't get any kind of things. Yes, you can declare it. But remember, final in essence, that's it. You can't just go on inherit or using override the method. Now comes with can I make a constructor as a final?
No, we cannot.
Sure. Make a constructor. Are you sure?
No, ma'am.
Why?
It will be act like a method, ma'am.
Because we initiate the instance variables in our constructors and making them final.
Okay. Sorry. So here, yes, like if it is a case like constructor can never be declared as a final. But what is constructor? We need to know before answering the question. What are constructor? Basically, can you inherit constructor? Obviously, no, because it is for class. For class, you are having, when you create an object, then a constructor will be called. So over here, you can't inherit it. You can't inherit it as you're inheriting as a class. So they are not in ordinary methods. So if that is the case, then how you can make it as a final? Can't make it as a final. If you want to do, then obviously your compiler will give you an error. Now comes with interface. So if I just want to make final as an interface, is it possible to make final as an interface?
No, ma'am.
No. Why?
Because my implementation is given in the
class only. So what is the difference between final method and abstract method? Because final also we cannot go on further. And abstract in a sense, just I just want difference between final and abstract.
No, final method has business logic, but abstract method doesn't have any logic. We have to provide logic for abstract method by overriding in the child class.
Yes.
Whatever the abstract methods we declare in abstract class, we must have to override these methods or must to give implementation about that method in a sub. But in final, what was the question?
Difference abstract. Between final method and abstract method.
Final method, right? So in final method, we cannot give such implementation or we cannot override methods.
Okay. So good.
In final method, we can override the methods, but in abstract methods, we have to override the method to implement the logic.
Yep, good. So now, what is runtime polymorphism?
That is a method overriding. Checks the method resolution takes place on the basis of which object is created.
Okay, still.
Ma'am, method to method implementation is resolved at the runtime base. So it is known as runtime polymorphism.
Still, only two? I need a lot of answers. Polymorphism is an important concept in Java. And coming to interview perspective, yes, they'll be on touching polymorphism for you. So I just want everyone to answer for that.
Dynamic dispatching method.
Still?
Resolve the overriding and compile time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
This is all runtime polymorphism. Mm-hmm. You can have casting that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Ma'am, it occurs when the program runs only.
Okay, okay.
Whatever the methods we override, that that will be invoked at the runtime.
Mm-hmm.
The method, the runtime polymorphism can be achieved by method override.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Runtime polymorphism is used in a program because when I execute the program, then that time can be occur the error. They can find and that time instant you can give the error. That time also called as runtime polymorphism.
Okay, good, good. So now, can you achieve runtime polymorphism by data members?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes or no? Think properly.
Data members, ma'am?
Yes. No, ma'am. You mean no, variables.
Ma'am, no, ma'am.
Repeat the question, okay? Can you achieve runtime polymorphism by data members?
No, ma'am, because method can be overridden because and data member cannot be overridden.
They are just inherited.
Okay. Yes, the answer is no. That's right answer. Good one. Now the next question is, what is the difference between static binding and dynamic binding?
Static binding is the method reservation will take place like the reference type, which reference is created, and the dynamic binding is method reservation will take place using the which method is created, sorry, which object is created, like the new keyword.
Okay.
Is also called as a static binding, mm-hmm. and runtime polymorphism is also called as a dynamic binding.
Okay. Still any differences? Now, I just want a sample code where to differentiate static binding and dynamic binding. A sample code, not lot of lines, just sample code. Can I get it within 10 minutes?
Yes.
You can paste it in the chat box or you can type it in your Eclipse, in your systems, whatever it's, but I just want code, that's it. A small code. 10 minutes is your time.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, is it done?
Can I share?
Yes, you can, please.
Ma'am, screen host is disabled the participant to screen sharing.
Yeah, once again, let me just run it up. Now it's fine, you can share.
So ma'am, here is a method, class M1 and M2 extension M1. So I have created another class that is test, where I have created a main method and created an object of M1 and printed the method hello. Here is the same method I have overridden. So if I'm creating of object of M1 only, it will print the hello. So if I am creating object of M2 only, it will print only hello, only world, that is here, M2. And if I am creating a reference of parent class and object of child class, and if I print the hello method again, and it will print the world, that is inside the child class, that is runtime polymorphism, ma'am.
Okay, that's great. So both the binding techniques done?
Again, ma'am.
Okay, what is the question I have asked there? Static binding and dynamic binding.
Yes, ma'am.
Different programs for that.
Okay.
Okay, that is what I asked, right?
No, so is it not the is it dynamic binding? Yeah?
Okay.
So I'm doing the static binding.
Okay, just perform it. Okay. So someone have shaded some dog one and dog two. Yes, guys, is it done? So I got certain chats. Aishwarya, static binding, you have sent it. Okay, good. And yeah, dynamic binding sent by Mohanta. Okay. Then Aishwarya, MSH, just whether it's going correctly or not. And then Mohanta, Navneet. Okay. So, yep, good. Almost you have sent, that's great. Yes, Satyanarayana. Just now you joined? Today itself, right?
Yes, ma'am, yeah.
Okay, okay. Try to join regularly, okay? Yes, guys, now almost it's time for you to on your videos and have a small interview. So now I just request on your videos one by one, please. Who wanna go first?
Yes, ma'am. Can I share?
Yes, I... yes. Okay. If I'm asking you to on, then I need to on, right?
Okay.
Yes, Mohanta. 1 minute about yourself.
Yeah. I am Dibbed Manto. I am from Odisha, but now I am staying in Bengaluru, Murugesapalle. I did complete my last qualification MCA 2019. I secured 70% in my MCA. Then I have joined JSPIDER like so on course, and I have completed my course. Then I have preparing my skill Million Light. My hobby is the learning new thing and learning new programming language. I have done by two project. One is the wedding management system, and another is the online shopping system. All about for me.
Okay, okay, that's great. So can you just tell about JDBC?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah, it is a database connectivity. We can Java code can be connected to a database. It's known as JDBC.
That's it.
Yes,
components of it.
Yeah, first, ma'am, we can load and register the JDBC driver and establish connection with the between database and Java program. And create platform from execute of SQL query and execute the SQL query and fetching the resultant data and closing of all costly resources.
Okay. Okay, that's fine. So can you just tell me about exception handling?
Yes, ma'am. Exceptional handling is a runtime error. We can handle by using try catch. There is a many access. There is a two type of exception: check and uncheck exception. Check exception is a class not found exception, and uncheck exception is the array index of bound exception and null point exception, etc.
Okay. Can you just tell me about abstraction?
Yes, ma'am. Abstraction is hiding the implementation and providing the functionality is known as abstraction. Abstraction cannot be create any object, and abstraction can be achieved abstract method and interface, and abstraction can be achieved 0 to 100%.
That's it, Mohanta. Do you find any different from your last and now?
Yes, ma'am. I increase day by day confidence.
Good, very good. And try to, did you try to hear videos in this coming weekend from the YouTube, how to give your introduction? Okay, you need to concentrate a bit on your introduction. And even how the slang and communicating vocabulary should be there. try to go through the videos which will be available in the YouTube about Java interviews. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Good, Mohanta. Good improvement from your end.
Yes, ma'am.
Yep, next. Just raise your hand, Mohanta.
Yes, ma'am.
Next.
Can I, ma'am?
So yep, go on. Saurabh.
Wait a
minute. On your video.
Yeah. Good evening, ma'am. My full name is Saurabh Kiran Kulkarni.
Mm-hmm.
Roots are from Latur, Maharashtra. But from last 5 years, living here in Pune for educational purposes, I did my engineering mechanical stream. And I completed from Srinagar Institute under Savitribai Phule Pune University. Currently, I'm pursuing a course in Java. I have a good knowledge in core Java. And even parallelly, I have a good knowledge in responsive web development as well as a web component development as well. I have a good knowledge in SAP as well. I'm well trained in that, well trained in material management module as well. When I was in college, I did 2 projects as well. One is an individual project, another one is a team project. I kept one hobby for myself to keep myself motivated, that is crafting. I would love to do crafting. And yeah. Ma'am, you are on mute. Ma'am, you are
yes. On. Yep, yep. So good, very good. So I just want to have a brief about the process. How do you connect from Java to database?
Sorry, ma'am, I didn't get you.
Connectivity from Java to database, a brief the process how you will be connecting.
Okay.
What are requirements, components,
the JDBC mechanism which we use to connect our application to database. So we have some driver managers used to connect our application to the database, which converts the native language. Suppose that connectivity in between our application and database. Apart from that, I can say we have some, we can use some we make some connection objects. We have create some statements. I'm in that process, ma'am, to learn the JDBC now. So I don't know how to explain the whole thing, but I know the basic things like these. Ma'am, you're on mute.
Your answers were not wrong. Your answers were right, Saurabh. So that's fine. It's fine. The answers were right. Yes, we required certain statements. We required certain applications. But the thing is, you required driver, and you required to go with certain statement for execution. So these all things were required. That's fine. So just get into it in depth. You have to go. Okay.
Yeah,
and
sure.
Coming to next question, I just want to know that. Why pointers is supported by C++ and why it is not Java?
Ma'am, basically using a pointers, it makes a complex. First part is that, and second is security purpose. Using pointers in, we avoid to use pointers in Java because in Java, whatever the memory is allocated is totally, so there is no external external user can directly access the memory of memory is allocated by JDBC. So using pointers, it makes risky our application and it's unsafe.
Mm-hmm.
That's why Java is totally ignored or avoid to use pointers.
Okay, that's great. Saurabh, what is wrapper class?
Wrapper classes, ma'am, basically Java, not a 100% object oriented language. So we need to when we have primitive data types, so we need to convert that primitive data types into objects. So for that purpose, we need a wrapper classes.
Excellent. That's it, Saurav. Even your communication was also really well and good. So just go in depth of the concept. That's it. No more suggestions for you. You are really good. You need to just go in depth of the concepts.
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
Thank you, Saurav.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
You can off your video and raise your hand, Saurav. Next one, please go ahead. Who wants to go on? Raise your hand, Saurav.
Good evening, ma'am.
Sorry, ma'am.
Good evening, Pratap. Raise your hand. You didn't get over here. You can raise your hand, right? In the Zoom. You can't find. In reactions, you will be having.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes. Who is Pratap?
Yes, ma'am.
How are you?
Fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Fine. Ready?
Ready, ma'am.
Go for 1 minute.
Yes, ma'am. I'm Pratap Pitsi, born and brought up purely in Bangalore. And I'm living in a nuclear family. My family consists of 4 people, father, mother, brother, and me. I have completed my graduation in St. Francis Digital College with the course BCA. With an aggregate of 85%, and I have completed my PUC in Holy Spirit View College with a course PCMC and with a 90%. And I have did one course in Udemy as a Java developer, and I'm currently doing a million lights course as in Code Java Bootcamp, and where I have learned all the concepts of the Code Java. I have a 2-month internship in Reformers Technology as I work as a front end developer. And that's it for me.
Okay, Pratap, that's good. So I want to know about polymorphism.
Yeah, the name itself.
Complete polymorphism. Got it? Complete concepts, whatever included, just go with it. Not with the definition, I want complete concepts. Please go ahead.
Yeah, okay, ma'am. The name itself indicates poly. Poly means more than one form. Polymorphism is ultimately it's an ability of displaying a message in more than one form is called polymorphism. 2 types of polymorphism you can tell it is static and runtime polymorphism. Static binding and dynamic binding comes under the polymorphism itself. The static binding is nothing but static binding occurs whenever we declare a method with final or with a static keyword, the static method occurs. But for dynamic polymorphism,
what happened? Go on, try it out.
Yes. Dynamically assigning a value to the object is called as dynamic polymorphism. Mm-hmm. At the runtime, we are going to assign a value so for the object, so it's called dynamic polymorphism.
Okay, that's good, Pratap. That's it. So only one question, that's it for your questions. So did you find any improvement from your last and now?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, fear is going day by day, and I'm very fluent with speaking the interviews. My contact also getting improved day by day.
Good. That has to happen, Pratap. So don't worry. You'll get still better and better.
Sure, ma'am.
That's it for you. So, you can off your video and raise your hand.
Thank you.
Next, please go on.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, Sudhir, go on.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, Sudhir. Just go on with your 1 minute.
Okay. So, hello, ma'am. Good evening. My name is Sudhir Chandra Sahu. I am from Odisha. I have completed my graduation in Sivaraman Global University. After that, I have joined the JS Spreader for Java Full Stack Development. After that, I am currently looking for jobs and currently taking part in the quiz of Million Lights University. And my hobbies are programming, learning new things on the internet, and leveling up my skills. Yes,
okay, that's great. So now, Sudhir, I want to know about constructors.
Constructor is a part of Java. That is, you can it will be created when the object is created. It will be created automatically. And if there is no constructor, if you don't create any constructor, JVM will create a default constructor for that. And
yep. Good. Now, next thing, I want to know about inheritance.
So, inheritance means acquiring the properties and methods, variables, everything from the child class to parent class.
Properties and behaviors. The objects.
Of the objects from parent class to child class. In this concept, two classes are required from which the properties are acquired is known as parent class, and to which it is acquired is known as the child class. The exchange keyword used in there for the classes, and the implements keyword used in is for the implementing from the interfaces.
Okay, that's great. That's it. So there. So, did you find any implement?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good. So, if you are finding, yes, for sure, there is an implement.
So you can prepare on something, ma'am.
You need to just go on depth and concentrate on your communication vocabulary. That's it.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Try to watch the videos. You will be developing on it. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Good. So next one, please raise your hand, Sudhir. Gulshan.
Yes, ma'am.
Yep. Go on, Gulshan. On your video.
Yes, ma'am.
Just go on with your 1 minute.
Thanks for giving me opportunity for my introduction, ma'am. My name is Gulshan and I am from Rador, Yamunanagar. And I am recently completed my graduation from JMIETI Rador, and that is BTech with computer science and engineering. And I have completed one project in my graduation, that is Zipper or Unzipper project. And my hobbies are playing basketball, football, badminton, reading books. That's
it. Okay, that's great. So, Gulshan, I just want to know about drivers which were used in connectivity for Java to database.
Ma'am, drivers?
Yes. In the code format, how you will give that particular line for the drivers?
Ma'am, drivers, ma'am, we give the class.forName. And then they give the
what you will do direct directly you'll be use, or you'll be register first and then you'll use.
First of all, import, ma'am, Java MySQL driver class.
Okay.
And then we will class.forName class and give the path of the drivers in that Java application.
Okay.
And then we will give the
just try to know the concept there in that line. First you will do registration and then you call upon. So try to just work on it. Okay. And just go on with abstraction.
Abstraction is a process in which we can hide the internal information of any process and showing the functionality. For example, when we call, we don't know the internal process of the calling system.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That is the abstraction.
Okay. That's good. So still, I just want to know why multiple inheritance is not supported in Java.
Multiple inheritance because, ma'am, class can be implements one interfaces.
So here, I have confused you with the question. Multiple inheritance, I'm just telling you, like it won't support it in Java. The thing is, yes, it is supported in Java through
interfaces. Ma'am.
Yes. So now got it? So concentrate on the question what I'm asking.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so my question itself is wrong, even though you are giving the answer. Just concentrate, okay?
Okay.
So, can I implement pointers in Java?
No, ma'am.
No. Okay, good. What is the rules for overriding, method overriding?
Method overriding, ma'am. My method overriding can be override with.
That's fine. Just go into those concepts. So, how do you feel from yesterday's and today's?
Good, ma'am.
Good.
Yes, ma'am.
I can just feel somewhat tense free.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you are laughing. Yesterday, you are not even moving, just straightforward. At least yes, today, you are just nodding something.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So just try to maintain it and try to go in depth of the concepts, Gulshan. You need to just go through the concepts, certain concepts, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yep. Good, Gulshan. You can stop video and you can raise your hand. Next one, please.
Shall I, ma'am?
Yes, go on, Jagdish.
Hi,
Jagdish. How are you?
Fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Good, fine. Jagdish, can you please go on 1 minute of yourself?
Yes, ma'am. This is Jagdish from Theni, Tamil Nadu. I did my schooling in Theni and I completed my BTech IT graduation from Kharkhavan Institute of Technology, Coimbatore.
Mm-hmm.
My hobbies are watching and playing sports and reading books. My overall percentage in my graduation is 78. My short-term goal is to join an organization and my long-term goal is to improve my position in that organization.
Okay, that's good. Now, I just want to know details about dynamic and static bind.
Static binding is the type where the type of the object is determined during the compile time. And in dynamic binding, the type of the object is determined during the runtime.
Okay, that's great. Great, good. And I just want to know about abstraction. Can we achieve 100% abstraction in Java?
I think no, ma'am. Abstraction is first. Abstraction is the object-oriented concept, object-oriented programming concept, where we show only the essential details of the program, and and non-essential details are hidden. We cannot achieve complete abstraction because we are unable to declare abstract classes at some point of time.
Okay, that's great. So, is there any concept to make abstraction 100% in Java?
I have no idea, ma'am.
It's interface.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Okay. Saurabh have answered. Good, Saurabh. Next, that's good. Very good from your end. So how do you feel from yesterday's and today's checklist?
From yesterday's to today, I have learned new concepts, ma'am. Mm-hmm. And that's the only improvement I made.
Yep. Good, Jagdish. You can just stop your video. And next one.
Thank you, ma'am.
Next, who wanna go on? Aishwarya.
Good evening, ma'am.
How are you? Good evening. How are you?
Fine.
Good. So, did you keep water beside you?
No, ma'am.
No. So you won't be hurried today.
No, ma'am.
No. Okay. Just go on 1 minute of yourself.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am, to give me the opportunity to introduce myself. My name is Aishwarya Kharbade. I am basically from Amravati, but currently staying in Pune. I have done my graduation in B, Computer Science Engineering branch. I have done my diploma in Computer Technology. Then my technical skills is C++, Java, and other skills are team management, problem solving, and critical thinking. My short-term goal is to give the job in reputed company like yours. And long-term goal is to achieve the good position in my organization. And that's all about for me.
Okay, that's great. Yes, Aishwarya. So I just want to know about polymorphism.
Polymorphism is a concept of object-oriented programming language. We can use the more objects and methods of the polymorphism and interfaces. There are the two types of polymorphism. First is the runtime polymorphism, and second is the compile-time polymorphism. Runtime polymorphism is also called as a static binding, and compile-time polymorphism is also called as a dynamic binding. Runtime polymorphism is used in a program. They can program can be executed, then that time we can accurate error can be declared. That's called as a runtime error and polymorphism. And compile time polymorphism, we can execute the all program and use some errors, then after compiling the program, then can declare the error, also called as a compile time polymorphism.
Yep, good. Can I know, can we point towards address of any variable?
Ma'am, please repeat the question.
Can we point towards address of any variable in Java?
Yes, ma'am.
Think.
Because, ma'am, Java is an independent language. We can.
What I'm asking is, can we point any address of the variable in Java?
Sorry, ma'am, but explanation is confused.
What is the concept of pointers?
Pointer, which is the concept to point accurate gives the address of program, but Java is not using.
See, now that is that is what you are very clear. Like if I ask pointers, question may come in this way also. What I'm asking, can we point towards address of any variable in Java? That means what I'm asking, is pointers possible in Java or not?
Okay, ma'am. I am confused.
Understood? No, don't confuse. You need to be strong. You will be getting this kind of questions itself.
It's not. I will strong.
Just go on. Aishwarya, your next question would be, what are access modifiers?
There are the three types of access modifier. Access modifier is also called as a visibility mode. There are four types of access modifier. First, okay. Private, public, protected, and default. private access modifier. Private access modifier is used to class. We cannot access in outside of the class. Mm-hmm. Public access specifier. Public access specifier is used many classes. As a declare the public, they cannot. We can run and execute the more than classes. Then protector. Protected is the most important concept are used in inheritance because as a declare the protected, they can use in this type, this class, that class we can declare the protected. And default access modifier, we can automatically default execute it. That's work in a class without not working outside of the class.
Okay, that's good. That's good, Aishwarya. Good.
Thank you.
Can you see the improvement from yesterday's and today's?
Yes, ma'am.
Yep, good. So if you can see, even I can see, you are a little bit free than stressed. So that is a good sign. So what you need to do is just off your video and we'll meet up again on Monday for the interview. So today you can just go on, observe others' interviews, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Good. So next one, please.
Hi, ma'am.
Hi. Who is this? Navneet, how are you?
Yeah. Fine, ma'am.
Fine, great. So Navneet, just go with the 1 minute of yours.
Yeah, sure. Myself, Navneet Krishna VC, and I am from Kerala. I have completed my BTech in Electrical and Electronics Engineering from College of Engineering, Adur, with a CGPA of 7.31. And after my graduation, I have done a short-term course in Java development. And my hobbies include watching movies, watching sports, playing football, etc. And that's about me, ma'am.
Yep, Navidit, just go on with complete explanation of static methods and static variables.
Static is nothing but it belongs to the class, and whenever we make a method start with using a static keyword, the method is called a static method, and we don't have to create an object to call that method. And whenever we make a variable static, it is called a static variable, and it is global in nature, so without creating an object we can access that variable.
Okay, that's great. So Navneet, can I just get that static binding and dynamic binding?
Yeah, when object is depending upon the compile time, it is known as static binding. And whenever object is cannot be determined by during compilation, it is called as dynamic binding.
Okay, yeah, that's great. So yes, Navneet, I just want to know about abstraction.
Yeah, abstraction is one of the object-oriented programming concept. Here we hide the implementation details and we use interface and abstract classes to achieve abstraction.
Okay, good. That's it, Navneet. Good. So you can off your video. Really good improvement, Navneet. You need to just go into the concepts and please be slow. So you have improved a lot. You are slowing down your speed, but somewhat you just go on trying. Okay.
Sure.
Yes. Remaining are fine. Fantastic from your end. So you can just stop your video and raise your hand. Next, please. Next. So we are having Ashish, Suresh Babu, and Neelesh. Yes, Neelesh. Yep, go on, Neelesh. Please go on with your 1 minute.
My name is Nilesh Vilas Godke. I'm from Pandharpur, but currently staying in Pune. I have completed my BCS graduation in Solapur industry. And I have recently completed MCA in Pune University. And I have 11 month internship in L&D Private Limited Pune. I have one Java certification course, Java development training in 6 month in Fusion Technology Solutions. And that's all about me now. Thank you.
Yep, that's great. So yes, Nilesh, I just want to know, what is prepared statement, for what it is used?
Prepared statement.
Yes. In JDBC, it will be used. That's okay, fine. Just go on with the exception handlings.
Yes, ma'am. We can use unwanted, unsecured data handle the exception handling. There are we can use in try catch and block exception handling. Checked exception. Checked exception. We can handle. There are two types.
Okay, that's great. That's great, Nilesh. So I just want to know about abstraction.
Abstraction is a technique we can use hiding the implementation details in a user. Highlight the data in users, yeah. And we can achieve abstraction. Interface and abstract class.
Okay. Yes. Yeah, but that's good, Nilesh. Just go on with the next one. What is polymorphism?
Polymorphism is one thing, many forms. We can use the. There are two types in polymorphism, runtime polymorphism and compile time polymorphism. Compile time polymorphism it is also called as static polymorphism, and runtime polymorphism is also called as dynamic polymorphism. We can handle polymorphism overriding and overloading methods. That's
okay, that's good. So that's it, Nilesh. Good, Nilesh, good improvement.
Okay.
But you know JDBC concepts, you need to go on.
I know JDBC, ma'am, but I'm little bit studied.
That's fine. I know that you know JDBC concepts because I have seen your practical thing also, but you need to be confident on that concepts.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, because connectivity is important as core Java. When you're going with
ma'am, your voice is down, ma'am.
My voice is down.
Yes.
Is it clear now?
It's clear. Yes.
Yeah. So as core Java is important, in the same scenario, connectivity also important. So okay, you need to go through it. So please just go through the individual concepts, drivers concept, components, and then JDBC, what are the statements used for executions. So these all things, we just go ahead. Okay, that's it, Nilesh. You can stop your video. So next, Ashish, and then Suresh, Prashant. Hi Ashish, how are you?
I'm fine, ma'am. How are you, ma'am?
Fine, great. Just go on with your 1 minute.
Yes, ma'am. First, thanks for giving me an opportunity to introduce myself. I have completed my engineering in 2019 from Indian VPS College of Engineering, Nasik. Then I went to Hyderabad and joined the Naresh IT Institute for learning Java and related frameworks also there. I have learned there Spring Boot, Hibernate, and I worked on a project in a supply chain management domain. The name of the project is Warehouse Application.
And my hobbies are to taste new cuisines and cooking. Mm-hmm. That's all.
Okay. Cooking is also your hobby?
Yes, ma'am.
That's great then. So, Ashish, here, I just want to ask a small question for you. So, I just want to know about static keyword. Is it only restricted to variable or method or class? What exactly and what is keyword and what we can, where we can use that static keyword?
Ma'am, we can use the static keyword with variables and methods. And we can use with the class for inner classes. Mm-hmm. And for static blocks also, we can use static keyword. And if static is, if you write static keyword in front of method or variable, then that means it is loaded at the time of dot class file. Mm-hmm. Of the dot class file. And any component which has static keyword, that means it is associated with the class, not with the object.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's great. So, Ashish, so I just want to know about static binding and dynamic binding.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, this static binding and dynamic binding, these are comes under the polymorphism concept. Static binding is method overloading and dynamic binding is method overriding. If you have multiple multiple methods with same name and there are different parameters, then this is a method overloading concept. And if you are if you want to provide business logic for same method name, parent class, then we have to override in the child class and provide the specific logic for the method.
Okay. Good, Ashish. That's it from my end. That's really fantastic speaking with you. Ashish, just go in depth of the concepts. So some technical terminologies you need to use while giving answers, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
That's it. So your communication and everything was fine. Only you need to improve your conceptual approach, some technical terminologies while giving the answers, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yep. Good, Ashish.
Thank you.
You can stop your video and raise your hands. Yep. Next, Prashant. Then Suresh. So that's it. We have done almost. Now, yes, guys, can we play a game?
Yes, ma'am.
Which game, ma'am?
Ma'am, can I?
Okay. Play your game.
Can I?
That's okay. Off your video. Off your video, Suresh. You are traveling or somewhere else, right? Off your video.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, guys. So,
ma'am, actually, I'm in the topic.
That's okay, Prashant. I can understand. You can stop your video. Okay. So now we are going to play a game, guys. So I want you to divide into two or three in a team, like two in a team. So almost we are having 12 members, 6 teams, right? 6 teams. So team one, like who wants to be in teams, you can just decide among yourself. I'll be giving you time of 5 minutes. Use chat window for that.
Again, ma'am, what is the game like?
No, first you divide into teams.
Ma'am, can you divide, because we don't know each other, so even we don't know each other's names properly, so can you divide?
Okay, you want me to divide?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyway, see, here I'm having some sequence. I'll read in that sequence so that divide among yourself. Mohanta and Saurabh. And okay. Sudhir and Gulshan. Jagadish, Aishwarya, Navneet, Neelesh, Ashish, Suresh, and then Prashant. So do one thing, Ashish, Suresh, and Prashant, three of you, one team. Because yes, those two are traveling, so they may not be available whenever.
Yes,
that's the reason. Okay.
Okay.
So now you know your teams, right?
Yes, ma'am.
For what to do, ma'am?
Yeah. No. So now, what you need to do is just lower your hands. Lower your hands. So now, I just want different answers from you, not similar answer. If I ask any question, every team has to give different approach answer. It's a technical game itself. It's not a complete question you will be having. You may have quote snippets. You may have different things. Based on that, you need to just answer. Okay? Clear?
Yes.
So, it's up to you. Let's see which team will be winning up. Okay? Are you ready?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Can we start the game?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. Okay. Now, your first question is, why is Java not a pure object-oriented language? So now, team one, please go. Not even team one. Whoever goes first, their team will pick.
Ma'am, because, oh God, it's so...
Okay, fine. Go with, let me pick randomly, okay?
Yes, ma'am. Okay.
Let me pick random name. I don't know even teams. I didn't just remember. So I'll just pick randomly. So I just want to give Aishwarya and team, like, I don't know the other teammate.
Yeah, Jagadish, ma'am.
Yep, Aishwarya and Jagadish. Go with your answer.
Java is not pure because... it does not support operators overloading and multiple inheritance.
Only one point you need to give. So it does not support operator overloading. And multiple inheritance, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, so, Java is an independent language. That's why it's not an pure object-oriented language. And object-oriented...
Aishwarya, yes, your team is done.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, anyone can answer. So now next team, Aishwarya and team is done. So one team is done. Other five teams were there. Four teams.
I can, ma'am.
Yep, go on. Go on.
Because Java is not object
oriented. Mohanta and team, right?
Yes, ma'am. Because Java is
you not and who is the other one? Saurabh.
It's me, ma'am.
Because you can discuss in the chat what you want to answer individually and you can answer one thing, okay?
Okay.
So I want every technical terminology answer. I won't accept the answers if you are giving like this. I just want professional and technical terminal answers, okay?
Yeah, well, you know,
go ahead.
Mohanta, can you?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Because Java is not object-oriented, 100% not object-oriented programming, because Java is supported primitive data type, so Java cannot 100% object-oriented program.
Okay, yeah. Valid point. This is not repeated, so fine. That's a valid thing. Okay, answer is accepted. Next team. Yep.
Hi, ma'am. Hi. This is Navneet.
Navneet, and who is that? Your teammate?
Nilesh, ma'am.
Nilesh, yep. Go on with your answer.
We can develop our code using static variables and static methods. So it is not object dependent.
Okay.
Yeah.
Only one. Both have to combine and give one answer. Okay, that's fine. Next team. Only three teams I got, Aishwarya and team, and Saurabh and team. And who is that just now given the answers? Navneet and team. That's it. Only three teams. So other two teams were left over.
So, ma'am, Java is not 100% object oriented, means like object oriented concepts are like because of primitive data types, it is not 100%.
Sorry, point got repeated.
I'm nothing left, ma'am.
Think.
Ma'am.
Yep.
Ma'am, because Java is not a pure object-oriented programming language because the operation performed on object must be only through method in object-oriented, but Java does not support this.
Ma'am?
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Go on, Suresh.
Ma'am, Java is not pure object-oriented programming language. It means you can represent with or without objects, ma'am. Data. You can represent data with or without objects, then we can call it as not a pure object-oriented programming language.
Okay. So here, now you have understood the game. Why I have kept the game?
Ma'am?
Is it clear to everyone why I have kept this game?
Yes, ma'am.
So now for every question, you will get 6 or 5 different answers. So different points you'll be getting.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
And everyone has to note the points. You'll explore your knowledge on that particular concept. Okay. So now let's go to the next question.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, be ready.
Yes,
see, it's up to you. Yes, if you're answering first, then your points, like you won't be lack of points. You can give only the points you know, the common points. If you are getting an opportunity last, that's it. So I'll just observe whoever raised hand first, I'll call it up. Okay. Next question is, I didn't ask the question, Mohanta. Please lower your hand. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
Now,
question.
What do you mean? Again, Navneet. Navneet, please lower your hand. I didn't ask the question. Let me complete the question first. Okay.
Sorry, ma'am. Accidentally.
Yeah. Okay. So, what do you mean by data encapsulation? Sudhir.
So, ma'am, encapsulation means wrapping up of data in a single unit, like in a object, sorry, in a variable or methods, is known as encapsulation.
Can you please repeat it?
Wrapping up of data in a single unit, variable, okay. And methods.
Okay, that's fine. Got it, understood, and accepted. Sudhir, and who is your team member?
Ma'am, Aishwarya.
Aishwarya. So, is Sudhir team member is Aishwarya?
No, ma'am.
Gulshan, ma'am.
Gulshan. Okay, Sudhir and Gulshan are done. Next, I can see Saurabh has been raised hand.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes,
so
Saurabh,
basically,
go on.
Basically, data encapsulation is a mechanism where we can all the data fields in a single unit together.
Mm-hmm.
The purpose behind the encapsulation is a security purpose.
Actually, single unit is done. Security, okay, accepted.
Yeah. We can achieve encapsulation by providing the fields. We can provide a private keyword to the fields. And we can achieve it by using data setter methods.
Okay, fine. Accepted, Saurabh. Next, yes, Aishwarya, your point is done. You have lowered the hand.
No, ma'am.
Yeah, please go on.
Exception is the hide some data and methods. That's also called as exception handling.
What my question is, encapsulation.
Sorry, ma'am. Encapsulation, yeah. Which is the hide the data and some errors. And some method.
No. Think the point. Yes, Mohanta, you want to give any different?
Yes, ma'am. By making a data member as private and providing the public method to access. And a real-time example for the there is a room. In room, many objects like fan, table, light, all the objects that are wrapped into a single room. Hello.
Yes, hello. Yes, Aman is just trying to have the answers. So they were just, that's okay. Fine, Mohanta. Lower your hands, gate. We'll go with the next one. That's fine. We'll go with the next one. JIT. Saurabh, you're.
JIT is here.
Yeah. Wait, I'll call. Saurabh, go on. Just one point.
JIT stands for just in time. It's,
that's it.
Yeah. No.
Let's give the opportunity for others. Yeah.
Okay. Shall I stop here? Because I have to move. But if you want, I can stop here.
Yeah. I'll just stop, Saurabh. Okay. Let others also just go on. Yes, Suresh, go on. Other than just in time.
Yes, ma'am. JIT is a compiler. It is used to perform. It is used for high performance purpose, and it is used to improve the performance of the compiler. Performance
okay.
of
it is a overall thing is for performance. That's it, right?
Yes, high performance.
Okay, and performance. For, enough. Performance is accepted. Fine.
And it Next. Is used to convert the byte code into
yes. Yes, Suresh, I can understand. You know the answer. But it's a game, right? So let's give others, okay? Yes, Aishwarya, go on.
JIT compiler, it's the components of runtime environment and improve the performance of Java.
No, performance again won't accept it.
Okay.
You should not use the word of performance. First point got accepted.
JIT compiler are used the bytecode and native the machine code at a runtime.
Yep. Yep. That's good. That point accepted. Yep. Next. Yes. Nilesh Goa wants to answer. Yes, Nilesh, go on.
JIT means just in time.
It's done. Just in time is done by Saurabh.
Part of JVM.
Ma'am?
Yep. Part of JVM is not done. That's good.
Ma'am? I can...
Yep. Mohanta, go on.
It increase the capability of a program.
Good. So, I hope you are enjoying the game, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, yep, yes, next ma'am. Question. Be ready.
Yes, ma'am.
Difference between equals and equality operator.
Ma'am, I can. Hello. Yeah, ma'am, equal, double equal is a operator and equal method is a object class operator and double.
Yeah, one point, that's it. Only one point.
Main point.
That's it. Okay. Yeah. Mohanta, I think you are done. Lower your hands. Next, Saurabh, go on.
Ma'am, the question is about equals and double equals. Yeah. Equals methods check the contents of the object and double equals. Mm-hmm. The references of the address the objects.
Excellent. Yes, Gulshan. Other than these two points, you need to go on.
Double equal is a ma'am operator and equal is a predefined
method.
Method, yes, ma'am.
Good. What a difference you have. But okay, good. Next. That's it. No more points. Okay.
Can I
question, ma'am?
Ma'am, can
equals,
I?
Equals and equality operator.
Ma'am,
equals method and equality operator. It's done. Actually, all the points you have covered. Almost.
Ma'am,
equal to operator is used for comparison of object reference and equals method.
It's done, actually. That point is also done. Almost, that is what you have covered all the
but
points.
Ma'am, an object class equals method is used for reference comparison, but if equals method present in string class, if you are calling it on the string object, then it is used for content comparison.
Yeah, good.
Like in string buffer, it is not overridden. So if you call equals method on string buffer object, then it will give reference of that.
Yes, good.
Yes,
so, yes, guys, almost like we are 5 minutes to end. So how do you feel the game?
Good, ma'am.
Nice, ma'am.
And the last point you have given, Ashish, very good, excellent point. So you just went to implement. This is how you need to think. So what I'll do is we'll just play games. That will be great. So that you are also will be involved and you'll be getting a lot of points. You will explore in depth what we need to do. You'll be on searching and thinking for the topic. That's what required. Yeah, that's great, guys. So I just want you all to be prepared with the database connectivity this weekend.
Okay.
Clear? Yes, so ma'am. Everyone has to prepare all the statements you need to prepare with MySQL, JDBC, components. And don't tell me like classifier name and all. No, they have some concept. That is code what you write and there is a concept behind it. Try to learn that thing. So what is a driver, how you'll be using, and how you'll register the driver, and how you'll be using after that for executing the queries, what are the functionalities you'll be keeping up, and these all under which package it exists. So each and everything, please try to note out each and everything you need to be prepared in this weekend. Monday, I want everyone to be given good answers as you are giving for Core Java, you need to give for database. Clear?
I'm only JDBC or Hibernate also.
Sudhir, you can go with Hibernate and all the advanced things.
No, ma'am. I can go with JDBC also. But...
Yeah. No. You can see if he wants to explore. Yes, for interview point of view, it's good. But whoever is going on completely fresher, they just have finished Core Java concepts and they need to go for connectivities. So as you know already, just go on further. Yes, Gulshan.
Tomorrow is your class or not?
Tomorrow morning 9 o'clock will start.
9 to 8 o'clock.
Fine.
Ma'am, this LMS, ma'am, this learning management system has. Hello.
Yes.
Ma'am, this learning management system has some topics like Spring Boot, Hibernate, and JavaScript. Also, that means this level is also given by DXC Technologies.
The thing is, learning management system, whatever they give, it's not completely towards one company. So one company goes with Core Java and database connectivity. The other company, they'll be going with somewhat advanced things. So that is very the different lags. So it's up to you, like how you're preparing and how you're giving up. So this learning management system, yes, it constant, but basic thing, everyone for a fresher, they'll be looking upon basic Core Java and database connectivities. If you're having advanced things, that is advantage.
I'm actually I worked very less on JDBC, but generally I prefer Hibernate with JPA. That's why I'm asking.
Yep, you can go with Hibernate and JPA, even whatever it is. It is connectivity, right? You should know the connectivity portal.
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am.
Yep. So yes, Gulshan, are you ready for tomorrow class?
Yes, ma'am. No problem. I am ready.
Yes. Same time. You are having class. Same time. No, morning, 8 o'clock. Self-learning class. I won't be available.
Ma'am, all of us will be, we need to have a little, ma'am.
Yeah, you all just go for your LMS and study yourself. Self-study.
Okay, ma'am.
Got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, so tomorrow and after tomorrow, it's weekend. How you can ask, like, is there class or something else? Just go on self-study and please go on with the connectivity. We'll meet up on Monday again.
Okay, ma'am.
Thank you, guys. Good night.
Good night, ma'am.
Good night, ma'am.
Good night, ma'am.
Good night.